verbs and we are on the past tense. Today we are looking at past perfect tense. This tense is used to express an action that's happened in the past before another action took place. Now let me explain. Assuming we have two things and we want to show that one happened before the other. For instance, I have John learned French. I may have John learned French. John traveled to France. The two sentences are expressed using the simple past. But assuming I want to show that the action of learning French came before traveling to France, then I will now express this using the past perfect tense. I will now have John had learned French before he traveled to France. So we said that the verb have and the past participle of the main verb is used. So I have here now had is the past tense of have. Learn is the past participle of learn. So I have John had learned French before he traveled to France. I may still have something like this. The rats had eaten the meat before I came. So I purposely added this one at this point so that you know that if you look at these ones, they are the weak verbs or the regular verbs that just add ed. So I want to show you that the irregular verbs can also be used here. So that's why I have the rats had eaten the meat before I came. I have again the march had already started when we arrived, meaning that we are planning to watch match, and when we came, the match had started before we arrived. So this they had the match had already started. John had learned French before the fire had destroyed the house. The rats had eaten the meat. Are all in the past perfect tense. Maybe I underline this for you to take notes. So the underlined ones are the past, are in the past perfect form. So you have the auxiliary had and the past perfect form of the verb. Notice that these forms are in the present, are in the positive or affirmative form. Then when we look at the negative form, remember, negative we used to show the opposite of positive. That is, in normal English, we have none, not, nothing to show negative. So in this case, we are using not. So in forming the negative form of the tense, not is added to the auxiliary had. So I now have, making the negative of this one, I have John had not learned French before he traveled to France. Margaret had not got home when it began to rain. So in other words, if you look at these negative ones, it means that the action here happened before this one or happened on top of this one to make it negative. Here, the action of learning French has taken place before John traveled. But here, it has not taken place. This now is the negative form of this. I hope we are following. Look at it very well. It's not confusing. And please, don't confuse it with the present perfect. The present perfect has used has or have to make it present. But the past perfect use had or uses had to make it a past or past perfect. So the next one now will be the interrogative form. Then for the interrogative form of the past perfect tense, we begin with the auxiliary. So we now have had John learned French before traveling to France. Had the match started when we arrived? Had the rat eaten the meat before I came? So these are the questions in the interrogative for the past perfect tense. And with this, we end the past tense. We have done the present. We have done the past. We are now going to look at future. But this time, we will only discuss simple future. I will not even discuss the simple future in full because there are other aspects. I just want to introduce it now. So here, in expressing the future action, we know that the future action is yet to happen. And the future can be in the next 1 hour, next year, or tomorrow, depending on the intention of the speaker, where he's trying to convey the exact time he means in the future. That's why at times people say the nearest future. Then here, in expressing the future tense, we use the modal auxiliary verbs, will and shall. In that normal simple present tense, the personal pronoun, first person, I and we, use shall, while the other forms of pronoun, that is, you, she, it, they, use will. The nouns also use will, whether singular or plural. So examples, I shall travel to Lagos next week, an action that I will perform in the future. Jane will visit her uncle in the evening. We shall write our exams when schools resume. There are other ways of expressing the future. For instance, we have the future intention. That will be our lesson for another class, so that you don't get confused. There again, I will explain more on the use of will and shall. Thank you.